Elon Musk is often described as a goal-getter, a perennial achiever, and one of the world's most prominent brainiacs capable of solving crucial life problems at the snap of his fingers.
When critics say you can't do this, your answer to them is,
we've done it.
I mean, for someone who revolutionized the way we travel to space, changed the face of the automobile industry, and introduced the world to many futuristic concepts, you'd imagine that not too many things would be difficult for him to achieve. However, there's one little problem that sort of gave Musk a hard time in the past, and it's none other than the dilemma of solid-state lithium-ion batteries. As always, Elon Musk has put on his thinking cap and he seems to have found a long-lasting solution, the all-new Tesla 4680 battery. In today's video, we'll tell you everything there's to know about this innovation. But first, let me walk you through the emergence of lithium-ion batteries and how they became the darling of the automobile world. Lithium-ion batteries are one of the most important electronic components to our lives today. Aside from providing power for electric vehicles, they also power things like phones, tablets, laptops, cameras, and most other essential gadgets that we use on a daily basis. Amongst all the different classes of batteries that exist today, lithium-ion is the most used battery type, and it's no surprise that it commands a market share of around 40%. And with the rising demand of consumer electronics and electric vehicles, that figure is expected to surge even more, at least until Elon Musk finally invents the Tesla 4680 battery that we'll be talking about in a bit.
There is a massive amount of lithium on Earth. Lithium is not like oil. There's a massive amount of it pretty much everywhere. Every vehicle in the United States can be converted to electric using only lithium that is available in the United States.
The origins of lithium-ion batteries date back to the late 1970s, when a group of scientists teamed up to begin the development of a rechargeable battery that would power all types of electronics, from mobile phones to vehicles and other gadgets. The result of their work back then is what we know today as the lithium-ion battery. But like they say, necessity is the mother of invention, and it's the same for lithium-ion batteries. The world was experiencing a severe oil crisis at the time, prompting Dr. Stanley Whittingham to explore the idea of a new battery. As a British-American chemist who worked for ExxonMobil, he was perhaps the best man for the job. Whittingham first started by deploying an inorganic chemical compound known as titanium disulfide and lithium metal as electrodes. But the combination resulted in different challenges, with one of them being safety. His fears were justified when the batteries short-circuited and caught fire, forcing him to abandon the experiment on the orders of his employer. Fast forward to the 1980s, John Goodenough, who is currently an engineering professor at the University of Texas in Austin, came up with another idea about batteries. Rather than using titanium disulfide like Whittingham did, he used cobalt oxide, and it worked. Half a decade later, Akira Yoshino, a professor at Meijo University in Japan, tweaked this experiment. Instead of using reactive lithium metal as anode, Akira used a carbonaceous material called petroleum coke, and that led to a groundbreaking discovery. He found that not only did the absence of lithium metal make the battery safer, it also made its performance more stable, and that was the first ever lithium-ion battery prototype. By 1991, Japanese electronics company Sony produced the first commercially viable lithium-ion battery, and since then, they've continued to prove their worth. The level of performance offered by lithium-ion batteries at the time was premium and way above what the lead-acid batteries that were invented in 1859 could deliver. To put things in perspective, the lead-acid batteries are 10 times larger and require 3 times longer charging times in comparison to lithium-ion batteries. Yet, lithium-ion batteries have a significantly higher density, and that explains why they took the electronics industry by storm. In fact, the Nobel Prize in Chemistry 2019 was jointly awarded to John Goodenough, Stanley Whittington, and Akira Yoshino for their contribution towards the invention of lithium-ion batteries. But despite all of this success, lithium-ion batteries are nowhere near perfect. And that has been a huge sense of worry for scientists and engineers. In fairness to lithium-ion batteries, they have done remarkably well all these years. But right now, scientists are looking for ways to make them more efficient and portable. And this has led to a number of research work already. But so far, the Tesla 4680 battery proposed by Elon Musk looks like the most viable option. There's so much hope around this battery cell that some analysts are already suggesting that it might spark a second revolution within the battery industry. That's certainly a bold call, but with Elon Musk involved, you can't bet against it happening. Interestingly, the Tesla CEO is just as passionate about batteries as he is with electric cars. Earlier this year, Musk commissioned the Tesla Berlin Gigafactory in Germany, which produces cars and batteries simultaneously. This facility, according to Musk, is the largest footprint building in the world. Initially, it is expected to have an annual production capacity of up to 100 gigawatt hours before rising to 200 gigawatt hours in a few years' time. Multiple sources confirm that the newest models of Tesla Model Y cars are equipped with the 4680-type cylindrical battery. And thanks to some teardown and analysis video released by veteran automotive engineer Sandy Munro, we've gathered some precious information about the battery. In a YouTube video, Sandy Munro revealed that 81.6% of the Tesla 4680 is made of nickel content. In addition, the battery is built with NCM811 cathode chemistry. Initially, industry experts expected Tesla to use the dry battery electrode concept on the two electrodes, but Tesla only applied it to the anode alone. The exact amount of cobalt and manganese it contains was not revealed, but it appears that there is no trace of aluminium in the battery's composition. Analysis of the anode showed that Tesla engineers used graphite as the anode's active material instead of silicon. Usually, around 10 to 15% of silicon is added to the anode of lithium-ion batteries to increase energy and energy density. But Tesla probably have their reasons for choosing graphite.
Most abundant element in the Earth's crust after oxygen. And it happens to store 9 times more lithium than graphite, which is the typical anode material in lithium-ion batteries today.
The battery cell measures 46 millimeters in diameter and 80 millimeters in height. The estimated capacity is said to be between 96 to 99 watt hours. Meanwhile, a black plastic holder is placed underneath the battery. Elon Musk has always prioritized reducing the cost of batteries, as that would ultimately help to cut down the manufacturing cost of electric cars.
What really matters is decreasing the cost per unit of energy of the battery pack so you can make the car affordable. That's actually the important thing.
Although it doesn't look like it yet, there's no doubt that the 4860 battery cells will make electric cars cheaper in the long run, especially with some of the numbers that are being floated around. According to reports, the Tesla 4860 battery is 6 times more powerful and efficient than other batteries, not to mention that it has the capacity to hold 5 times more energy than its counterparts. Perhaps the only negative is that it is twice as big as the Panasonic 2170 battery, but motorists wouldn't mind as long as it gives them more traveling range. Lastly, the Tesla 4860 battery is said to have an all-new tabless structure, which means the charging time will be incredibly fast. In case you're wondering how fast, experts believe that a 0 to 80% charge will take just 15 minutes, compared to the previous standard charging time of 25 minutes. And you could replenish the battery from 0 to 50% within 7 minutes. Those are unbelievable numbers right there. There are speculations that Tesla could supply this revolutionary battery cell to other automobile companies, but that's not confirmed. Although that seems like media talk at the moment, we cannot completely rule it out. In fact, Tesla expects to hit a battery production capacity of up to 3 terawatt hours by 2030.
We're expecting to make on the order of 3,000 gigawatt hours or 3 terawatt hours per year. I think we've got a good chance of achieving this actually before 2030, but I'm highly confident that we could do it by 2030.
That's a feat that has never been achieved even by the world's biggest battery manufacturer. All of these numbers bring Elon Musk's extraordinary contributions to the tech industry into focus, cementing his place in the history books. Thanks a lot for watching the video till the end. Be sure to check out our next highlighted video here for you, and we will see you there.